Happy Veterans Day. My name is Jeff Arnold, and I am proud to be your OCC Veterans Coordinator. For me, Veterans Day is about recognizing our veterans. At OCC, that's an everyday thing. Today, I want to share some information about the post-9/11 student veteran. I recently read an article put together by the Institute of Veterans and Military Families at Syracuse University and Student Veterans of America. The article starts off strong, shares some good information, and closes strong. At the end, there's a nice tribute to our World War II veterans. The article is written in first person with the post 9/11 student veteran speaking to the viewer. I will share some parts of the article and interject some personal thoughts. As I walk across campus with my backpack full of books, people see me as a student like all the rest. This is good because I want to fit in. I want to belong. At the same time, I know I am also something else. I am someone who carries a set of experiences and perspectives informed by my decision to serve in the nation's defense during a time of war. I am someone who joined the ranks of 3.9 million Americans who volunteered for military service since the terrorist attacks of September 11, 2001. I am also someone who made the decision to go back to school after separating from military service. I am a post 9/11 student veteran. Most of the student veterans are between the ages of 25 to 34, and they come from a host of different backgrounds and cultures. They were most likely to be a member of the U.S. Army, which equals 47%. The Air Force comes in at second with 21%, followed by the Navy at 18%, then the Marine Corps at 12%, and the Coast Guard with 2%. And here's something that's very noteworthy. Almost half of our post 9/11 student veterans are civilian soldiers, members of the National Guard or the Reserves, 45%. Nearly one out of every two student veterans are still serving their country. And I want to thank them for that continued service. Let's take a look at OCC student veterans and see how they compare to the national average. Here at OCC, the Army makes up 52.5%. Surprisingly, though, second place goes to the Marine Corps, 24%. That means nearly one out of every four student veterans is from the Corps. The Navy holds its average similar to its national average. And the Air Force is 6.5%. And here at OCC, the Coast Guard makes up 0.6%. There are many stereotypes for the student veterans. One such belief is that they chose the military service after high school because they did not have the academic skills to succeed in college. Nothing could be further from the truth. Student veterans excel academically and on average outperform their non-military peers. Research demonstrates that on average, student veterans maintain higher GPAs than traditional civilian students. Additionally, once they start in college, they are more likely to persist and graduate at higher rates as compared to non-veteran students. So to be clear, the most significant challenges student veterans face are not related to their ability to succeed in the classroom. Instead, their challenges are typically social, cultural, and often practical. I want our student veterans here at OCC to know that we want to understand your needs and concerns. And yes, we care about you. When student veterans arrive on campus, they will likely be older than their fellow students and have a more global range of personal and professional life experiences. Like many other veterans of previous eras, student veterans share a common bond with other veterans of all ages. We tend not to seek the health and wellness services that we need, even if they are available and accessible. As a vet of many years with experience as a veterans benefit counselor, I'd like to share a personal observation. We veterans share a common bond. We have a lot of pride and we're stubborn. I believe it's that pride and stubbornness that keeps us from seeking help. For our OCC student veterans, your Veterans Service Office is excited to keep you informed. And please know we are here for more than just your educational needs. We understand the resources available to you through the Department of Veterans Affairs, and we want to help assist you in making those connections. OCC's Veterans Services Office is located at the Auburn Hills campus, and we serve all five of our OCC campuses. Those campuses are Auburn Hills, Highland Lakes, Orchard Ridge, Royal Oak, and Southfield. I love the end of this article because it ends with our veterans' optimism. I am also confident and entrepreneurial, and my military experience taught me how to work with other people. It gave me self-confidence and helped me get ahead in life and grow as a person. Because of this, I bounce back from personal, professional, and organizational setbacks more quickly and completely than those who have not served in the military. All traits that translate well to making me a contributing member of my campus community. While pursuing a college degree may come with some challenges, it is nothing that my student veteran peers or I cannot handle. In fact, history makes a strong argument for why this nation's colleges and universities should do more to open their doors to men and women like me. Consider that today many historians would argue the original GI Bill, the Servicemen's Readjustment Act of 1944, is among the most important legislative act in the history of this country. Because after World War II, it empowered more than 8 million veterans to pursue higher education upon leaving military service. Among that group were three presidents of the United States, three Supreme Court justices, 14 Nobel Prize winners, 24 Pulitzer Prize winners, 91,000 scientists, 67,000 doctors, 450,000 engineers, and countless other members of what has been famously described as the greatest generation. Before I finish with our author's last paragraph, I want to acknowledge Ryan Thayer. Ryan is the second photo from the left. He is an Air Force veteran and a proud OCC student. If the recipients of the original GI Bill are any indication, just imagine what our generation of veterans could accomplish if this nation's colleges and universities acted boldly to empower our students and citizens. From where I sit, meaningful investments in the educational success of people like us who have shouldered the burden of this nation's longest wars is not only the right thing to do for our veterans, but also for our academic institutions and for the future of our nation. I am a post 9/11 student veteran. I am empowered.